to the Honourable Keith Rowley, Prime Minister of the Republic of Trinidad and Tobago. Senator the Honourable Kazim Hossain, Minister of Rural Development and Local Government. The Honourable Colin Burt, Minister of Finance. The Honourable Stuart Young, Minister in the Office of the Prime Minister and Minister in the Ministry of Legal Affairs. Minister Camille Robinson-Regis, Minister of Planning and Development. Permanent Secretary in the Ministry of Rural Development and Local Government. Deputy Permanent Secretary in the Ministry of Rural Development and Local Government. Members of Council of the Port of Spain Corporation. Former Mayors. Former Members of Council. Members of the Protective Service. Members of staff, distinguished guests, members of the media, members of the diplomatic corps, and the citizens and stakeholders of Port of Spain, ladies and gentlemen, good morning. Port of Spain became a city in 1914. The ordinance was passed on May the 29th and was proclaimed by the governor on June the 25th, with the first city councillors elected on November the 2nd, 1914. Today, with a population of approximately 40,000 people, or 12,300 households, and 5,600 businesses, Port of Spain is a reflection of two centuries of immigration and diversity, expressed by the cultural callaloo of our African, Indian, French, English, Spanish, Portuguese, Italian, Venezuelan, Chinese, and Syrian-Lebanese people. Port of Spain, a financial center, a cultural hub, and the capital jewel of the Caribbean, is but a microcosm of a greater Trinidad and Tobago. I have no hesitation in saying that each one of us is intimately attached to this city. But on the ground, the picture is quite different. For in the deep love of a spiritual and physical oneness, we all share as we experience the depth of the pain we all carry in our hearts as we see our home tear itself apart, as it has become a base for pernicious behavior taking root in our backyard. Today I say to you that the challenges we are facing are real. They are serious and they are many. They are not easily solved in a short time frame. Amidst the pain and honor, we find pride that I feel that has been chosen to represent the city of Port of Spain. I stand here today humbled by the task before us, grateful for the trust you have bestowed, and mindful and appreciative of the efforts by my predecessors. The last few years have been economically challenging for us, but be assured that as we go into the new year, we will continue moving forward and capitalizing on new opportunities. We will see the many projects that are in the pipeline finished and confront the issues that lie ahead. As a new council, this gives us the chance for a fresh start, though we wrestle with aging infrastructure and stretched budgets. We have to focus on smart growth, which will identify and nurture the very best opportunities for expansion, plan ways to cope with the city demands, explore investment partnerships, embrace technology, and manage expenses. As we begin our journey with a sense of optimism and hope for the future of this place we call home, we start with the values that each of us holds there. My admiration is for us to enjoy the city and to bring it to a sense of stability and enjoyment for all of us. My administration will immediately begin to develop a mid to long-term range plan that will look 10 years forward and put in place a strategy which includes becoming a city that continuously work on a strong and safe neighborhoods, where residents, schools, and businesses work together, and where the business community can operate in tandem with the government, all in the shared vision of a world-class city for all. My team will create a working environment where our performance-driven employees are accountable for their actions and will take every opportunity to forge stakeholder consensus with the local population and business community. With my 14 years experience in local government and my 33 years in the financial services sector, and extensive experience in management and leadership, my priority is to fulfill and facilitate improvement in the quality of life of the citizens of the city of Port of Spain. My council and administration will focus on crime and security for the city, sanitation, vending, homelessness, parking and traffic congestion in the city, the flooding that has been brought and besieged the city, and for recreational purposes, create more green spaces in the city. Today, I stand before you, and I would like to say that this is our city. This is our home. We must preserve it. This is our city. We must cherish it. This is our city. We must take good care of it. This is our city. We must ensure that is a modern city. Ladies and gentlemen, I dedicate my time, the 3 years that I have, to ensuring that the burgesses of this city feel very comfortable day and night, and I will work with all the necessary bodies to bring prosperity and enjoyment to the city of Port of Spain. I thank you.
Thank you very much, Your Worship, Mr. Joel Martinez. I would like to say thank you very much to outgoing Mayor, Mr. Karen Valentine. But before I bring my remarks, I would like to acknowledge the Honorable Prime Minister of the Republic of Trinidad and Tobago, Dr. Keith Rowley, Mrs. Camille Robinson-Regis, Minister of Planning, Mr. Colin Imbert, Minister of Finance, Mr. Stuart Young, Minister in the Minister of the Prime Minister's Office, and Minister in the Attorney General's Office. Councillors, Aldermen, distinguished ladies and gentlemen, the family of Mr. Joel Martinez, distinguished ladies, again, members of the media, Your Worship, the work has begun, and I am instructing you, the CEO, and your council, that the country is going to do a clean-up drive in the middle of next month, around the 15th. So I am asking you to instruct your public health department and your engineering department to find all those derelict vehicles all over the city of San Port of Spain. I love San Fernando. And I love my country too. And I really love to serve. That is why I am in the ministry, to try to make a difference. So as I said, I want you to find all the derelict vehicles within the city of Waterspain. And I am sending a message to all mayors and all chairmen and all CEOs within the country. We are going to plan this project. The planning has already begun. And from the 15th, together with the Ministry of Planning, the Ministry of Works, and all the other state enterprises, we are going to clean up all open lots. The engineering department will find all these dilapidated buildings within the city and the country, and we are going to try to get rid of them. We are asking for volunteers, and I want to take you back to San Fernando. In San Fernando, we put together a team which is called a volunteer network. We started off with 5. We are strong 600. And when I left there, I asked them to continue. And these volunteers came out with their vehicles, their equipment. They donated food, water for the cleanup. We had this go in, and everybody got on board with us. So I'm asking you, Your Worship, and the CEO and your members of council, to have this volunteer network within your corporation, and it will do a lot. People want to give back, and they don't know how to give back. And we have to inculcate in the children now how to start to volunteer from a young age. So we start in the schools. We have a lot where I came from, and everybody wanted to be a part of it. So the work has begun, Your Worship, and members of council. And I am here in the Ministry of Rural and Local Development to give you your full support. I am not going to run the ministry from any ministry. I intend to go to all corporations. And I want to have a day at every corporation where we'll have a tongue meeting, where we will hear the voice of the people who put us in office. You agree with me, right? Yeah. So I will be here, and once a month I'll be going to each corporation, and we're going to have this meeting because we have to fulfill the needs of the people. So ladies and gentlemen, I want to thank you for having me. And to outgoing mayor, I just wanted to say, I hold the same title like you, former mayor, and I wish you all the best in the future. We work together. You did your best. I always say, if you get an opportunity to serve, whether it's 1 month or 1 year, you do your best. Because serving is an opportunity that Almighty God has given to all of us. So thank you, and have a beautiful morning.
Thank you very much, Your Worship, the Mayor of Port of Spain, Alderman Joel Martinez, Minister of Local Government, Senator Kazim Hussein, my cabinet colleagues, the Minister of Finance, Colin Wimblett, Minister of Planning and Development, which is Camille Robinson-Regis, Minister in the Office of the Prime Minister and Office of the Attorney General, Minister Stuart Young, other members of Parliament, outgoing Mayor Karen Valentine, outgoing councillors, new councillors and aldermen, burgesses of the city of Port of Spain, fellow citizens, members of the security services, members of the media, ladies and gentlemen, I apologize for my terrible voice. But I have to be grateful for small mercies, 48 hours ago, I couldn't say a word. So I'm making considerable progress. I was hoping that I would be here and not have to say anything to you. But I be enlisted on the program, so I would try to make my few remarks. And I trust that you can hear me as I try to join the celebration this morning of placing in office a new executive for the city of Port of Spain. I just want to make one or two points which would be important to us at the level of the cabinet. And that is that those of you who have taken office today, you have taken office hopefully in the acceptance that you are not an ordinary council. You're not an ordinary executive. You are the executive management of the capital city of the nation of Trinidad and Tobago. And that being so, while you speak about Port of Spain as your city, being that the city of the burgesses who reside within the boundaries of the city of Port of Spain, Port of Spain is more than that. Port of Spain is the city of every citizen of Trinidad and Tobago by virtue of its designation as the capital city. It is a place of location which is entered into by many more than the burgesses who live within its borders. So as you manage the affairs of the city, you are not managing the affairs for those persons who reside within the city, but also for those tens of thousands of persons who come into the city on a daily and nightly basis to participate in city life, whatever that life might be. That might very well be one of your heaviest challenges, to operate the city so that it can satisfy the needs not only of the burgesses of the city, but of those who spend significant hours within the city. And from that standpoint, your workload would have to include issues such as transportation into and within the city. And therefore, the whole question of the suitability of the arrangement for traffic in the city, particularly parking, is an issue which I trust that this executive will address. You are not the first executive of the city of Port of Spain. We've had many executives before, and the issue of parking has always been a challenge. The absence of proper traffic flows within the city is an indication of one area of improvement which is sorely needed. It is my expectation that in collaboration with the central government and with the proper initiative and quality of management which I expect to emanate from this executive, that the whole question of modernization of parking arrangements in the city of Port of Spain would be one of the objectives of this executive. And by that I mean, I trust that we can move to the threat and the promise of parking meters in the city of Port of Spain to executing the installation of parking meters so that there can be some proper arrangements for the utilization of the streets of Port of Spain. Free parking in a city is something that only works well in a very large city with very large streets and a very small population. Our city is very congested, the streets are very narrow, and it is very heavily trafficked. And while we would like to see people come and use the city, the right to free parking is not a right enshrined in the Constitution. And therefore, I'm calling on the city of Port of Spain to take steps to make better arrangements for parking. The city of Port of Spain is the cultural center of the nation. And of course, culturally, we know what to do when we go to other people's countries. But when we are home in Trinidad and Tobago, we certainly don't know how to behave or how to cooperate with the legislation, the laws, and the regulations. I'm calling on the city of Port of Spain to set about to improve the quality of life and to let you know from now that it is my expectation that there will be no improvement in the quality of life in the city of Port of Spain without proper enforcement of the laws and regulations that are meant to establish that quality of life. And by that, it is against that background that at the level of the central government, one of the aspects of local government reform, which is coming your way, is an expansion of your city police department. I know that you've had a police department for quite some time, and that department is referred to as market police. Well, at this time of year, and given the nature of the quality or absence of quality of life in the city, when we expand your constabulary, we're not just expanding it to take care of issues in the market. We're talking about general enforcement by way of improved patrols and, of course, getting the benefit of more uniformed officers in the street to bring about an improvement in safety and security and the enforcement of the regulations. As I speak to you now, there's one person who is constructing and is living permanently in the Queen's Park Savannah. And if you don't do anything about it soon, by the time the next function of the city, we might be approached by the Association of Queen's Park Savannah Dwellers. Because when you allow something to happen that ought not to happen, others are looking on to see what is going to happen. And if nothing happens, then you create a new aspect of our culture. And of course, our culture is the culture of how you could demand that, where the man going to live. And when you do that, it leads to a general deterioration. And at the end of your term, you would have survived 3 years, and you would have made no improvement in the quality of life of the city of Port of Spain. So I would like to see city work and the effort of the corporation focusing on things that we know can be done. The whole question of street dwellers in the city, no one has a right and an entitlement to live on the street, on the pavement. We do have some arrangements for taking care of those persons who have found themselves without a shelter of their own. And if that is so, then those persons who are on the street with no place to go ought to be made to go into those shelters. And if you don't do that, you will end up with a situation like Shacken Street, which at 5 o'clock in the morning is an open sewer. So it's one thing to talk about wanting to have investment in the city and to do this and to do that. But if you turn a blind eye to some of the happenings in the city, there will be no improvement in the quality of the city. One of the things that happened to the city of Port of Spain over the last 20 years or so is a reduction in the resident population in the city. The city has good infrastructure, which can support a larger population. And it is the objective of central government that that infrastructure be made to sustain more persons, meaning that we accept the city of Port of Spain as our capital city, and we will work with you to ensure that you create the environment in which more people can reside and have a better quality of life. So, as a cultural center, you are required to lead the nation with respect to things cultural. You are the center of Carnival, yes. But every year you celebrate City Day. And I want to hold out to you that while we love a mud mass in Trinidad and Tobago, every City Day doesn't have to be a mud mass day. There are lots of other things that we can do. Your city is full of art and culture. Find other ways besides mud mass to celebrate City Day. And of course, you did mention a while ago, and I want to hold you to it, that particularly at this time, when our revenues are considerably challenged, that one of the challenges of this executive, like others, is to make sure that you make the most of what little resources you have and set about ensuring that as you manage the affairs of the city, that you ensure that you get for the burgesses, you get for the burgesses value for money. Very soon, I think it is in March, we are aiming to implement the procurement legislation, and it will apply to all those who are involved in managing and spending public monies. And the public servants who work with you, your staff, all of you, will have to ensure that as you obtain goods and services spending public monies, that you would now be under law required to conduct those transactions in a particular way so as not to be in breach of statute which demand that certain kinds of activities take place. What that is hoping to do and is expecting to do is to ensure that you get the benefit of competition, the benefit of efficiencies, and as we move to implement the local government exercises that we have spoken about in the recent election which brought you into office, a number of changes will be coming your way. I ask you to cooperate with the public service, cooperate with the central government, use your initiative, have a vision for what you want out of this reform, and as we go step by step giving you more authority, we would like to believe that you would be worthy of receiving that authority and using it all for the benefit of the burgesses that you represent. We expect that the city of Port of Spain will demonstrate to other local government bodies how local administration could bring about an improvement in the quality of life of all our citizens. You are the lead city in the country, and therefore you are the lead executive, and you have a duty to demonstrate a higher quality of performance. I know that you all represent one political party, and there's a danger in that you do not have an opposition to pull up your socks. I just want to say to you that you are not a group of people who come on your own. You represent a political party with tremendous experience, and Mr. Mayor, you have joined a long line are very distinguished citizens, and I expect that you too will make your mark so that when your picture is on the wall as a mayor who had served, we will want to point out to what you have accomplished, because it's not just a question of serving for 3 years, it's about accomplishing change for the better. I have great expectation during this term that as we make the efforts to bring about local government reform exercises, and even as we are doing so against reduced expenditure, we expect that we can bring about significant improvement. So the city of Port of Spain is waiting on you to see what your work program is, to see what you will address, to see what you will change, to see what improvement in the quality of life will take place in Port of Spain. And being the cultural city, being the entertainment capital of the nation, being the financial capital of the nation, being the area of the nation where opportunities come if only by virtue of a gathering of people, you have your work cut out for you for making Port of Spain an area of economic growth, an area of safety, an area of employment, an area of investment, and an area of pride for all the people of Trinidad and Tobago. I wish you well in your term, and we depending on you. We look forward to a very successful term of office, and may God bless you and your executive, and may God bless us all in Trinidad and Tobago.